In our place, in our galaxy, you'll create a scale model comparing the solar system to the Milky Way galaxy to help your audiences put these two structures in perspective. Here's the basis for the scale model. If we shrink the solar system down to a bit bigger than a quarter, our galaxy, the Milky Way, would span North America. We're going to shrink the solar system using the average distance from the Sun to Pluto, which is how far?
Five and a half hours.
Good. To the distance across a quarter. Anybody else have a quarter? Now keep those quarters in your hand as we go through this. Okay, so the distance from the Sun to Pluto is 5.5 light hours. Now the Milky Way galaxy, the island of stars that we live in, is 100,000 light years across. How big do you think the Milky Way galaxy would be if the solar system from the Sun to Pluto was represented by the distance across this quarter? Bigger than this deck?
Huge.
Oh, yeah. Sure. It'd be about 2,500 miles across.
Oh.
Can you think of anything that's about 2,500 miles across?
North America.
Yeah, North America, sure. Let's review real quick. How big is our solar system on this scale?
Size of a quarter.
Quarter. How big is the galaxy?
North America.
North America. Great. Now we know how wide our galaxy is. Let's figure out how thick it is. Well, out where we live, about halfway out from the center of our galaxy, like we said, out here in the suburbs, so to speak, it's about 1,000 light years thick. 100,000 to 1,000. So that's about 25 miles thick. But let's think of it another way. Commercial airplanes fly about 7 miles high. So this is about 3 times higher than commercial airplanes fly. How big does an airplane look from the ground that's 7 miles in the air?
Very small.
How small would this look 7 miles high?
It might be invisible.
Virtually invisible. Yeah, you probably couldn't see it. And our galaxy is 3 times that thickness. And this quarter is our solar system, located about halfway out from the center, or about over the Rocky Mountains, if you want to think of it that way. So now imagine yourself very, very tiny, shrunk down onto that quarter, flying over those Rocky Mountains, and you look out at the vastness of our galaxy. Okay? But wait a minute. Something's missing. At the beginning, what did we say? When we look up in the sky, we can see that our galaxy is full of?
Stars.
Sure. Right. There's about 200 billion stars in the Milky Way galaxy. Let's build a mental picture of 200 billion birdseed. Okay? Let's use this birdseed to represent the stars in our galaxy. These are a little too big for the stars that would actually be in our North America-sized galaxy on that scale, but we're just using them as an illustration. Okay. Now, imagine a football field surrounded by a wall about 4 feet high. How high is about 4 feet? Roughly there. Yeah, that's right. So think about that football field with a 4-foot-high wall all around it. We're going to take a bunch of dump trucks and fill up that football field with that bird seed, and that represents about 200 billion stars.
Wow.
Is that a lot of stars?
Yes.
Sure. Now, how deep on the football field are those stars?
Four feet.
4 feet, right. But we're not quite done yet. How big was the galaxy on the scale that we were building?
North America.
So what do we got to do with all those stars that are on the football field?
Spread them out.
That's right. We got to take about a third of them and put them over the center of the United States, roughly around Iowa, Kansas, for the central bulge. And then we got to take all the rest of them and spread them out all over North America, 25 miles deep. Okay. Now does it seem like so many stars?
I think so.
Are they pretty well spread out?
Yeah.
Sure, yeah. Sirius is about 8 light years away. It's one of our brighter stars. And it's about a quarter of a mile away on that scale, 8 light years. Down by the school, about. Okay. Now Polaris, the North Star, is about 11 miles away on this scale. Now our solar system, once again, shrunk down to the size of this quarter, flying high over the Rocky Mountains. Imagine yourself very, very tiny again, and you're way up there. Now you're looking straight up or straight down, you're going to see just a few stars, right? But if you look off into the distance toward the Kansas area, you're going to see all the light from those stars just fading and fading, getting dimmer and dimmer, and until they fade into a haze. Just like when you look over a city and you see the most distant lights fading into a haze in the distance. Okay? So look up in the sky, and you see that faint band of light up there? That's the plane of our galaxy surrounding us. Okay? And our solar system is suspended among those stars. And when we look above or below the plane of the galaxy, we see just a few stars. But when we look through the plane of the galaxy, we see the light from billions of distant suns fading off into the distance.
To tell this story, you might prefer to use the PowerPoint titled Our Place in Our Galaxy. Other ways you can use this activity and this scale are outlined in the manual.